If you don't watch it, it'll provoke some people to envy and jealousy. And God just bless them. And God just move it, but they can't have it. It's the truth. Be careful who you share things with. Please read. Well, let's stop there, Ruby. Who should have been more excited about what God was doing for him? Shouldn't it have been his brother? It should have been his brothers. As in the natural, so is in the spirit. Sometimes your own brothers and sisters in the house of God got a problem with you. Did I stop? Everybody that go to church ain't happy to see God moving in your life. Everybody that's in church ain't happy to see God. Oh, you want me on the Lord's side? You love with God. You live with Jesus. You just smiling. You happy? God is blessed. I'm living holy. I'm walking upright. I'm traveling upright. God blessed. I'm living. God blessed around. They looking at you like, really? He ain't blessing me like that. Why is this you? You gotta be careful. Let's read the rest. So his own brothers wasn't even excited about it. His own brothers wasn't excited. The ones that you thought should have been excited about it ain't. It shouldn't surprise you. This will happen to Joseph. Please read.
And he told it to his father and to his brothers, and his father rebuked him and said unto him, what is this dream that thou hast dreamed? Shall I and thy mother and thy brother and we come to bow down ourselves to thee and to the earth? And his brother envied him, but his father observed the same.
But he still got rebuked. See, he was telling what God showed him, and he got rebuked. Slow down. He was telling what God had showed him, and he got not a pat on the back, not a dab on the heart. He got rebuked. What? So that's telling me, be careful who you share things with. Because sometimes people need you. Sometimes people, they are downright with you. And you just share what God is doing. Let's go to Matthew chapter number 1 and verse 18. So we're dealing with the Old Testament children and the New Testament children. Now God is going to bring a parish. Go back and read about the Old Testament children. Go to Genesis chapter 37 or 39 when you leave the time and see how God is going to do what he said he's going to do. Everything that God showed you in the dream, it came to pass. Everything came to pass. And the ones that say that was in his hill in Joseph had to bow down to him. God brought the pain. Let's go to Matthew chapter number 1 and verse 1 through Matthew chapter 1 and verse number 18 to 25. Matthew chapter 1 verse 18 to 25. Are we there yet? Amen. Let's read down. See, that was the Old Testament Joseph. Let's deal with the New Testament Joseph. It's amazing that name God used. See, God got precept, God be a brother, precept line, God be a brother line. And God does that to help us remember what he wanted to get a message across to us. He dealt with the Old Testament Joseph in dreams and visions. In dreams, he's going to deal with the New Testament Joseph in dreams as well. Matthew chapter 1, verse 18, please read.
Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child in the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately.
Oh my Lord. Oh my Lord. See, before Joseph even married, Joseph was a good man. And according to the law, she could have been what? God knew who to hook up with. God knew who needed to be her husband. Because there are some men so religious and holy. They would kill. They would kill. There's some men so I have no apology. They're so hardcore religion, they would have stoned. And they would have been justified upon the old covenant law. Even though they would have gotten in trouble with God and had no concern, knowing that was God. But he was willing to put away pride. In other words, a little bit out of feet, they got a situation here. And I can't explain it, you can't explain it either. So we're just gonna not do this marriage thing. I'm gonna put you away pride. That's what he was gonna do. He was gonna give it a divorce before he got together with him. But he wasn't gonna stop. I love people like that. I love people that can operate in mercy and grace and not in judgment. Because sometimes what we need is mercy and grace and not judgment. Sometimes. Amen. Go ahead and read, please.
While he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary, thy wife. For that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth his son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. For he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done, that it may be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife.
Stop right there. He done what God showed him. No priest came to him. No prophet came to him. Nobody gave him confirmation. He received that angel appearing to dream as being his confirmation. Wow. Now, sometimes you gotta be careful what you dream, because sometimes you may just say to you one day now. Me and my wife, we be playing with the dreams sometimes, trying to turn us off the dreams and say, Lord, you just ate too much money. That was that hamburger. Yeah. Must have had ice on or something, I don't know. Yeah, I'm some less spiritual about that dream at all. You see a dog flying in a dream, I don't know what that means. A flying dog? I don't know what that is. God help me with that one. I don't know. But you see how God dealt with him and he obeyed. Amen. Amen. And verse 20, go ahead and read the last verse of that chapter, please. What does it say? He what?
And knew her.
Verse 25.
And knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Let's go to Matthew chapter 2, verse 15, 11, 15, and we're going to wrap it up tonight. We only got a couple of but I want y'all to start writing down your dreams. I want y'all to make an investment into a little cheap dollar store tablet you want, and you can write on it dreams and visions. And put it beside the bedside, and grab one. Write it down. I'm telling you, God will show you stuff to come. He'll talk to you. If you live. Amen. Amen. Matthew chapter 2, verse 11 to 15. Please read.
And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshiped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. And when they were departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying,
go ahead. Oh, I just pause you right there. The wise men was being led by the dream. The wise men had enough sense to realize if an angel of being one of God in a dream, that means I need to follow the rest. It didn't say they had the Holy Ghost, but the Bible says they were warned of God in a dream. Wow. Pastor, we got the Holy Ghost. God, I'm sure, but I dream like that. No, we don't. We don't have to. But sometimes he will. I said, well, he don't have to, because he's able to talk to us when you got the Holy Ghost on inside. When you speak it to him, when you've been filled with that talk of the Holy Ghost, and let the Holy Ghost come and take over your mouth, and you begin to speak in another language, God is able to talk to you and deal with you. But sometimes you still are short in your dreams. Please read this clause.
And when they were departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying, arise, and take thy young child and his mother, and flee unto Egypt, and be thou there until I bring thee word. For Herod will seek the young child to destroy him. When he arose, he took the young child and his mother by the night, and departed into Egypt, and was there until the death of Herod, that it may be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, out of Egypt have I called my son.
John chapter 16 and verse number 13, and we're done for tonight. But I want y'all to take some time. Even you young children, God has shown us stuff through our children. God has shown us stuff through our children, really, our own children. He's shown us that. Showing us stuff through our children. So when our children begin to say, I had a dream, you need to listen. If your child says, I had a dream, you need to take heed. Just because you're the mother don't mean that you're the only one that God talked to. Just because you're the father don't mean that you're the only one God talked to. And it's amazing. It's amazing. When the Holy Ghost wants to show somebody something, he ain't going to ask your permission. When the Holy Ghost desires to show somebody something, he ain't going to ask your permission. He just going to show. Yes, Lord. My children just asked, I am going to go to tell. God has shown me stuff in dreams. Sometimes your child, they think they get away with something. He has shown me in dreams. So, parent, if your child think they get away by doing stuff they got to be doing, and God will give you a dream, take it serious. Take it serious. Last year, John chapter 16, verse number 13. Please read that with love. So the love that we've done. John chapter 16 and verse 13. Please read that.
How be it when the Spirit of truth is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak. And he will show you things to come.
And he will show you things to come. Now, I want to say this real quick. When God showed me death, I prayed this.
Yes, amen.
No. See, somebody, I showed you dead. The devil, that's a lie. You better pray against that.
Amen.
Pastor Jones, I saw you stretched out in front of this casket. Please pray for me. But I pray against it. If I see anyone in church, if I have a dream that anyone in church dies, I'm praying against it. God may have shown you so you can pray against it and intercede for that person. Don't come telling me you saw big time prophet or prophet I saw today.
Yeah.
The devil is a lie. I come get that in the name of Jesus.